Hello everyone. Today our topic is introduction to proofs, basic definitions, and types of mathematical proofs. First, definitions. A theorem is a mathematical statement which is proven to be true. They also can be referred to as facts or results. Example of a theorem: if A and B are consecutive integers, the sum of A plus B must be an odd number. You know that the integer N is even if there exists an integer k such that n equal to k, and the integer n is odd if there exists an integer k such that n equals to k plus 1. Two integers a and b are consecutive if b equals a plus 1. So the sum a plus b equals to a plus a plus 1, which is 2a plus 1. And this is the form of an odd integer, hence proved. A proof is a valid argument that establishes the truth of a theorem as the conclusion. Statements in the proof can include the axioms, for example, 3 multiplied by 4 equals 12, something assumed to be true, the premises, and the previously proved theorems. Lemma, a theorem that is not very important, that is helpful in the proof of other results. We sometimes prove a theorem by a series of lemmas. Corollary, a theorem that can be easily established from a theorem that has been proved. A result which follows directly from a theorem. For example, if A plus B equals C, then an example of a corollary is that C minus B equals A. Next, conjecture, a statement proposed to be a true statement, usually based on partial evidence or intuition of an expert. Once a proof of a conjecture is found, it becomes a theorem. It may turn out to be false. I believe that this is true, but I have no proof yet. Example, make a conjecture about the next number in the pattern, 4, 6, 9, 13, 18, etc. The difference between the first two items is 2. The difference between the next two items is 3. The next difference is 4. The next difference is 5. So we can predict that the difference between the next two items is 6. 18 plus 6, 24. And the next item, 24 plus 7, 31, etc. Another example of a conjecture, every even integer greater than 2 can be written as the sum of two primes. For example, 18 equals 13 plus 5. This is not a theorem since it is not proven yet. Next, types of mathematical proofs. There are several known types of mathematical proofs. Direct proof by contraposition. This is an example to indirect proofs. Proof by contradiction, proof by cases, and proof by induction. First, direct proof, or also known as proof by construction. In a direct proof, to prove that P implies Q, we first assume that P is true and use axioms, definitions, previously proved theorems with rules of inference to show that Q is also true. Example 1, if N is an odd integer, then N square is also odd. We start by assuming N is an odd integer. This implies that there is some integer k such that n equal to k plus 1. K is also an integer. Then n square equals 2. 2k plus 1 all square, which is 4k square plus 4k plus 1. And this is equals to 2k square plus 2k plus 1, and this is the form for an odd integer. So n squared is also odd, hence proved. Example 2, show that if n and m are square numbers, then n multiplied by m is also a square number. We start by assuming both n and m are square numbers. This implies that n equal, for example, r square, and m equals s square. So n multiplied by m equals r square multiplied by s square equals to r multiplied by s all square. Hence proved. Next, proof by contraposition. And this method is an example of indirect proof. In proof by contraposition, we prove P implies Q by assuming not Q and proving that not P follows. P implies Q is equivalent to not Q implies not P. It makes no difference logically, but sometimes the contrapositive is easier to show than the original proof. Example one, show that if 3n plus 2 is an odd integer, then n is odd. We start by assuming 3n plus 2 to be even. This implies that n equals 2k for some integer k. So 3n plus 2 will be 3 multiplied by 2k plus 2, which is 6k plus 2, or 2, 3k plus 1. So that 3n plus 2 is even. Since the negation of conclusion implies the negation of hypothesis, the original conditional statement is true, which means that 3n plus 2 is even, hence proved. Example 2, show that if n equals ab, where a and b are positive, then one of these integers should be less than the square root of n. A less than the square root of n, or b less than the square root of n. We start by assuming that both a and b are greater than the square root of n. This means that ab is greater than n, so that n is not equal to ab. Since the negation of conclusion implies the negation of hypothesis, not P implies not Q, the original conditional statement is true. Hence proved. Next, proof by cases. In this method, we evaluate every case of the statement to conclude its truthness. In general, there may be more than two cases to consider. Proof by cases says that to show P1, disjunction B2, disjunction, etc., disjunction PK implies Q, and this is equivalent to P1 implies Q, conjecture, P2 implies Q, conjecture, etc., conjecture PK implies Q. Example, show that if an integer n is not divisible by 3, then n square equals 3k plus 1 for some integer k. N is not divisible by 3 is equivalent to n equals 3n plus 1 for some integer n, or n equals 3n plus 2 for some integer k. In the first case, n square equals to 3n plus 1 all square, which is 9m square plus 6m plus 1, which is 3m square plus 2m plus 1, which is 3k plus 1 for some integer k. In the second case, n square equals 3m plus 2 all square, which is 9m square plus 12m plus 4, which is 3m square plus 4m plus 1 plus 1. And we can rewrite this as 3k plus 1 for some k. In both cases, we obtain the desired conclusion. So the original statement is true, hence proved. Next, proof by contradiction. The proof by contradiction method makes use of the equivalent. P is equivalent to not P implies F0, where F0 is any contradiction. One way to show the latter is as follows. First, assume not P is true, and then show that for some proposition R, R is true and not R is true. That is, we show that not P implies R, conjecture not R, is true. Proof by contradiction is based on the logic that if the converse of a statement is always false, then the statement is true. The steps for a proof by contradiction are: step one, take the statement and assume that the contrary is true, which means that we assume the original statement is false. Step two, start an argument from the assumed statement and work towards the conclusion. Step three, while doing so, you should reach a contradiction. This means that this alternative statement is false, and thus we can conclude that the original statement is true. In this method, the statement we are trying to prove must have only two possible outcomes. Example, prove the following statement by contradiction. The sum of two positive integers is always positive. We start by the opposite, which is the sum of two positive numbers is not always positive. Or there exist two positive numbers, A and B, that sum to a negative number. This means that A plus B is less than zero. This sum needs to be negative or less than zero. If we subtract B from both sides, we'll have A less than minus B. Since A plus B implies that A is less than minus B, when both A and B are positive, which means A is also negative, this contradicts the supposition that there exist two positive numbers, A and B, that sum to a negative number. Hence, our original proposition is true. The sum of two positive numbers is always positive, hence proved. And the last method for today, proof by induction. Inductive proofs are like direct proofs in which every step must be justified, but they utilize a special three-step process and employ their own special vocabulary. Steps for proof by induction: the basis step, the hypothesis step, and the inductive step. Example, proof by induction that for n greater than or equal to 2, then n cubed minus n is always divisible by 3. If a number is divisible by 3, then we can write it in the form 3r for some integer r. In step 1, we check for n equals 2. 2 to the power 3 minus 2, 8 minus 2 equals 6, which is 3 by 2, so divisible by 3. Next step, induction step. Assume that it's true for n equals k, which means that we assume that k cubed minus k equals 3r. For n equals k plus 1, we have k plus 1 cubed minus k plus 1, which is equals to k cubed plus 3k squared plus 3k plus 1 minus k plus 1, which is equals to k cubed here minus k plus 3k squared plus 3k. And using the assumption, this is equals to 3r plus 3k squared plus 3k, which is 3r plus k squared plus k. And this is divisible by 3, hence proved. So the principle of induction implies that n cubed minus n is divisible by 3 for all n greater than or equal to 2. For today, that's all. Thank you.